The Quest. I'm writing a story about a quest, said Emma, but I'm sad. I don't know what to put next. What to put next? I don't know what a quest is, said Beth, so I don't think I can help you. It is a journey that someone makes to look for something that's been lost, said Wilma. But still didn't understand what Wilma meant. So Wilma read the story to her. Long ago and far, far away, there was a beautiful land called Alam. Flowers grew everywhere. Animals lived in the woods and the forest. Everyone was happy there. In a big cave deep underground was a crystal bell of Alam. It was very beautiful, even in the dark. Cave it glowed like fire. When it rang, its note was like music. The sound of the bell told every animal, every plant, and every tree when it was spring or summer. The evil Grimlock lived outside Elm. He lived in the cold, black mountain of Grim. He wanted the crystal bell of Elm, and he spent years looking for it. At last, Grimlock found the bell. Now it will be mine forever, he said. Grimlock took the bell, bowed to the land of Grim. He carried it through the forest. Then he crossed the rocky desert. At last, he reached his castle high in the mountain. High in the sunlight, the bell looked so beautiful that Grimlock could not bear to look at it. Without the bell, the land of Alam became dark and gray. Flowers grew in the winter and were killed by the frost. Snow fell in the summer. The people of Alam were sad and unhappy. All the beauty had gone from the land, and the days were cold and long. Emma looked at Biff. That is as far as I've got, she said. What do you think? It is brilliant, said Biff. So will someone go on a quest to try to get the bell back? That's right, said Wilma, but it will have to be someone brave like a knight. Dad came into Biff's room. Biff and Chip had to go to the dentist for a checkup. I don't know how long I'll be at the dentist, said Biff. Do you want to go home, Wilma? Do you mind if I stay and get on with my story? Asked Wilma. I've got an idea. After Biff had gone, Wilma picked up her pen and began to write her story about the quest. A girl should bring back the crystal bell, she said. Yes, a girl should go on the quest. Suddenly, the magic key began to glow, and Wilma was taken into a magic adventure. The magic took Wilma to the land of Alm. The land was cold and bare. Grimlock was waiting for Wilma. He was hiding behind a tree. He wanted to stop Wilma from going on the quest. So he turned himself into an old woman. As Mima went by, Grimlock said, "Hello, my dear. What are you doing in the forest?" "I can't tell an old woman," Mima said. "I'm going to rescue the crystal ball from the evil Grimlock," she said. Grimlock pointed, "Then go that way," he said. Mima went along the path that Grimlock had shown her. Soon the ground became wet and muddy. Mima's feet sank into the mud. "Is this really the right way?" she wondered. Suddenly she sank into the muddy swamp. "Oh help, I'm sinking, help me somebody." Mima was frightened. She was sinking deeper and deeper. She couldn't get out of the swamp. Suddenly she saw a white unicorn standing on the edge of the swamp. "Don't be frightened," it said. "Hang on to this branch and I'll pull you out." "Quickly, jump on my back," cried the unicorn. "We must get away," as the unicorn galloped through the forest. Grimlock fired an arrow at Wilma. "You'll never bring back the crystal ball," he shouted angrily. "You'll never get past the dragon." At last, the unicorn stopped. "You must go on alone," it said. "This is as far as I can go. There is a ring tied to a ribbon round my neck. Take the ring. It will only give you one wish. Don't waste it." Mima took the ring and the unicorn galloped away. Mima walked across the rocky desert. She was hot and tired. She almost wished for a drink, but she stopped. She didn't want to waste her wish. Then she heard a shout. It was a gnome. "Help me, someone," shouted the gnome. "Be quick before it is too late." Mima untied the gnome. "Oh, thank you, thank you," he cried. "I was tied up here by Grimlock. This is where he feeds his dragon. But why did he want to feed you to the dragon?" asked Mima. "Because I burnt his toast," said the gnome. Suddenly the gnome began to tremble. "Oh no," he squeaked. "The dragon's coming for his dinner." "Oh help," said Mima. She looked at the ring. "Maybe I should use a wish to kill the dragon." The gnome gave her a lemon. "Try this," he said. "Dragon hate lemons. They can't bear the smell." Mima began to peel the lemon. "Will the dragon run away?" she asked. "I don't know," said the gnome. "I've never tried it. This is a chance to find out." Chew, and the dragon. It gave a terrible roar and flew away. "Worry," shouted the gnome. "You did it." "I was very frightened," said Mima. "But the lemon worked." The gnome handed Mima a mirror. "Take this mirror. You'll need it to kill the basilisk. The basilisk is even worse than the dragon. What's a basilisk? Asked Dunma. And how can I kill it with a mirror? It is going to kill you, says the gnome. When you see it, don't look into his eyes, or you'll be turned to stone. Hold up the mirror and let it look into his eyes. Does it work? Asked Wilma. I don't know, said the gnome. I've never tried it. This is a chance to find out. Suddenly, with a great roar, the basilisk charged at them. Wilma held up the mirror, and the monster was killed by its own terrible eyes. Hooray, called the gnome. You did it, see. It is turned to stone. I was really frightened, said Wilma. You are brave and good, said the gnome. I've never met a brave, good person before. I'm going to help you with your quest. The gnome took Wilma up the mountain to Grimlock's castle. They went up a steep path. The gnome knew a secret way to get into the castle. This way to the kitchen, whispered the gnome. Come on, but don't make a sound. I'm frightened, said Wilma. Wilma and the gnome didn't see anyone in the castle. At last, they came to the room where the crystal bell was hanging. Wilma gasped when she saw it. She couldn't believe how beautiful it was. I've been expecting you, said Grimlock. You can spend the night here, yes, Grimlock. Tomorrow I'll feed you both to the dragon. Oh dear, oh dear, says the gnome. What shall we do now? Wilma looked at the magic ring. It's time I made my wish, she said. Wilma's wish started to work. The bell began to ring. Its sound grew louder and louder. It rang so loudly through the castle that cups and saucers broke and the glass in the window cracked. Hour after hour, the bell rang. Grimlock's ears hurt as the bell grew louder and louder. Grimlock could not bear the noise any longer. He tried to smash the bell with a hammer, but it wouldn't break. Stop it! Stop it! Cried Grimlock. I can't stand it. The sound of the bell will kill me. I think my ears will burst. At last, Grimlock asked Wilma if she could make the bell stop ringing. I can, said Wilma, but you must let me take it back to Alum. If you don't, it will begin to ring again, and it will never stop. Take it, said Grimlock. Take it back to Alum. So Wilma and the gnome took the bell back to Alum, and the quest was over. When the bell returned, Beauty came back to the land of Alum again. Birds sang flowers bloomed, and new leaves grew on the branches of the trees. Even shared Wilma and the gnome. سماجيكي began to glow. It is time for me to go, said Uma. She gave the ring to the gnome. The magic is used up, she said, but keep the ring to remember the quest. The gnome's eyes filled with tears. Thank you, she said. I shall never forget you. Biff came back from the dentist. Sorry, I was a long time, she said. Did you finish your story? Did they get the bill back? Uma gave Biff her book. Why don't you find out? Said Uma. You can read it if you like.